Now, my friends, I don't know whether you know it or not, but we stand today on the threshold of freedom here in Birmingham, Alabama. I've said it over and over again that if the Negro is to be free, he must free himself. The Supreme Court cannot free him. 9 years ago, the Supreme Court rendered a decision. And do you think that Alabama has done one thing about integrating its public schools? And they're going to sit around and still not do anything about it. But today I sat in the room with one of the top men in the Justice Department, and he paced the floor. He couldn't sit down. He changed from chair to chair. He walked from one side of the room to the other side. And I said that this man is walking simply because the Negroes of Birmingham have decided to stand up for their freedom. Now, you know what happened Easter Sunday. They brought the dogs out, turned them loose on our people. You know what happened last Friday. They brought the dogs out, and they tore the garments from our people. They turned the water hoses on. But what happened yesterday to the dogs? They still have those same dogs. They still have the water hoses and the water, but they didn't use it. We have already won a victory here in Birmingham. And all we've got to do is to keep marching. Do tomorrow what we did today. And do it the next day, and then the next day we won't have to do it at all. Because yesterday we filled, day before yesterday we filled up the jail. And then today we filled up the jail yard. And on tomorrow, when they look up and see that number coming, I don't know what they're gonna do. And don't you worry about your children. This committee behind me now is worried, simply because they got a report that the children are out in the fence. Out in the fence. Don't worry about your children. If anything happens to them out there in that fence, we gonna sue hell out of the city of Birmingham. Don't you worry about it. Whenever you are taken into custody, it is the responsibility of the law enforcement officers to provide for your safety, for your protection. And we are going to see to it. Soon as I get away from here, I'm going to get on the phone and call this Justice Department official that is here in the city of Birmingham. If he doesn't do anything about it, we're going to call Bobby. And if Bobby doesn't do anything about it, we're going to call Jack. And Jack is known for getting things done. He's famous for getting things done. We are going to see to it that your children are protected and cared for. What I want you to do is to join your children. We need you on tomorrow at the 16th Street Baptist Church in large numbers to join your children and go to jail for your children. Do you know they've been arresting us across the years for nothing? If you didn't talk to a white man right, they would arrest you. And even if you looked at a white woman wrong, they would arrest you. Now, why can't you go to jail for something now, since you've been going to jail across these years for nothing? You must join your children in going to jail. So I invite you to be at 16th Street Baptist Church on tomorrow. And then not only will we be there, but we're going to be somewhere else. I'm not going to tell you exactly where we're going to be, because I see right now that some of you want to find out where we can be, where you can go back and tell it. So I'm not going to tell you that at all. Reverend Shuttlesworth cannot be here tonight because he's somewhere right now talking over this problem with some people whose minds are troubled and whose hearts are heavy. I don't know how long it'll be now before I'll be separated from you, because I'm supposed to stand before Judge Brown on Wednesday at 1:30 for parading without a permit. And they tell me that the judge gives you 6 months and then fines you $100. And Lord knows I don't have any $100 to pay any fine. So there's nothing for me to do but to get my work clothes ready. So if he doesn't have space for me, he may as well make space for me. So it may be that I will not be able to be with you in these mass meetings, because I may be on the farm somewhere. But you have got to keep this freedom movement alive. The question of filling up all the jailhouses in Birmingham, we're past that mark. They're already full. We've filled them up in Jefferson County. The question now is to fill them up in Alabama. We want to send so many tomorrow that they'll have to take them down to Montgomery, Alabama. We want to be free. Don't you want to be free? Do you want freedom? Why don't you say something when I'm talking to you? Do you want freedom?
Yeah.
That's the way to say it. We got a reporter here, and I don't want him to say that you got a lot of Negroes who meeting here, chewing gum, and don't want to be free. I want him to know that we want freedom. Put it, Mr. Lomax, in your book, that the Negroes of Birmingham, Alabama, are sick and tired of segregation and discrimination. And they can put us in a fence if they want to. That's their responsibility. They can leave us out in the rain if they want to. Many of us have lived in shacks across the years that it rained through. We've been in the rain before. We are not afraid of the rain. We are not afraid of the water hoses. We are not afraid of the dogs. All of us have been sprinkled, poured, or baptized once before. And we are willing to be baptized again. Baptized by the city of Birmingham. We have paid water bills across the years. Let them pay the water bill now. We will stick together. Come to 16th Street tomorrow night. And don't let anybody divide us. Don't let anybody separate us. Put our shoulders to the wheel. It won't be long before we will march in the freedom's land. I'm on my way. I don't know about you, but I'm on my way. And I'm not going to let anybody turn me around. I'm not going to let Bull Connor turn me around. Not going to let the city jail turn me around. Not going to let the water hoses turn me around. I'm not going to let the Uncle Toms turn me around. Not going to let the nervous Nellies turn me around. I'm not going to let Governor Wallace turned me around, because I want to be free. Not only do I want to be free, But I got news for you. I am going to be free. I'm going to be free here on this earth. Or I'm going to report in person to God in heaven and tell him why I could not make it. I'll be able to tell him at least, Lord, I tried. I did the best that I could. Keep moving, Birmingham. The eyes of the world are focused upon us today. Mr. Castro is looking to Birmingham. Mr. Khrushchev is looking to Birmingham. Mr. Kennedy is looking to Birmingham. But the communists may as well not be looking here thinking that we're going to give up our democracy and turn to communism. No, no. They'd be glad for us to give it up and turn to some foreign ideology. But we're not going to give this country up to the white man. We have fought too hard for it. I fought during World War II, and my buddy was injured in a foxhole, and he told me as I went back to bind up his wounds, Ralph, go on, don't leave me. I'm finished now. I can't make it. You go on back to the United States of America, where you can enjoy democracy for me. And if he could die in Europe, if it becomes necessary, why can't I die in Birmingham? The trouble with us is that we're too afraid to die, too afraid of going places that will cause us to die. Now, I want to tell you, if you're afraid of dying and afraid of going places where people have died, when you go home tonight, you better stand up in the corner and not go to bed, because more folk have died in the bed anywhere else than I know. Now, let me make this final plea to you. And that plea is to get ready to suffer. Get ready to suffer. Get ready to suffer. I don't care what they inflict upon us, we're going to stick together in this struggle. Don't participate in violence in any form. Give up your guns. Give up your ammunition. If they want to beat you, let them beat you. If they want to kick you, let them kick you. But keep marching to freedom and let no man turn you around. And someday right here in Birmingham, Alabama, we will walk into freedom's land, just like John walked into Jerusalem.